secret of crispy audio is in placing your microphone closer to your mouth. That's it. That's the secret. Now I can go and watch other videos.
But if you really want to know a little bit more about audio and voice in particular and how to make it sound crispy and juicy in Premiere Pro, I have some great tips in this video and you'll be surprised how easy it is to do. Stick around. It looks like spring is knocking at winter's door here in Poland, and I'm so happy about that as it's getting less depressing in this part of the world, and I can finally feel vitamin D on my face. But today's video is not about that. Today I'll show you what exactly you should do to make your audio sound a little bit better in Premiere Pro, especially your voice, if you want others to pay attention to what you're saying. And so, without further ado, let's get into the first tip. Guys, I repeat that in every video of mine related to audio, that the main secret of perfect sound is getting the microphone closer to your mouth. Without that, anything you do in Premiere Pro will be just fixing and repairing what you've screwed during recording. So don't rely on software. Don't think that you'll be able to make audio sound significantly better just by adding some effects and filters in Premiere. No! In the world of sound, the phrase "let's record it fast and fix in post-production" doesn't work. You need to put some effort, at least by placing the microphone closer to your mouth. Why is that so important? Because by doing that, you will pick mainly your voice frequencies and not the sound of your fridge, traffic, or your cat. If you place the microphone closer to your mouth, you will be able to decrease the volume level of your microphone and thus will cut even more unnecessary sounds. This tip is so simple, it costs you nothing, but it increases your production quality tremendously. Remember about that. Second tip. After importing your audio to Premiere Pro, I mean voice, music, sound effects, and putting them on the timeline, remember that if you want to tell the viewer a story, never, never make your music or sound effects sound louder than your voice. Your voice is more important. Nobody wants to make additional effort and struggle with understanding what you're saying having loud music in the background. If you're not sure if your music is loud or not, or if you don't have much experience, just mute it at all. Or decrease the level to minus 15 or minus 18 decibels. This is what I normally do if I have a loud music track. Another option is to choose a track which is not interfering much with your voice. I'll show you actually now two examples for better understanding. So now I'm talking to you with loud music in the background, and I'm sure you want to click off as it sounds really weird. And this is a calm music which is not so interfering and you feel pretty comfortable listening to my voice. Second option is obviously better, but not only because the volume of the music is lower, it also doesn't have vocals. The viewer's brain doesn't want to process two voices, yours and singer's. It wants to hear only one voice, yours. So pay more attention to the music you choose, don't make it loud, and you'll be heard 100%. Third tip, and it's more related to overall audio and voice perception by the viewers, and I'm not actually sure whether such rule exists or I made it up, but let me think that I came up with it by myself. So the rule that I always use in my videos for an online audience is cut lows, boost highs. Look, in order to make your voice sound crisp and clean, you don't want to leave all the muddy and dull sounds that stick to the lower part of the frequencies generated by your voice. Instead, you want to add more brightness to your voice to make it pop up among all other sounds in your video. Of course, different people have different voices. Unfortunately, mine is not so great if we're talking about brightness. It's more dull, so I have to cut my lows and boost my highs in order to achieve the result I want. So if your voice is also not so bright as mine and you would like to make it a little bit better, here is how I do it for myself. Let's add some sound effects to our clip on the timeline. Go to the Effects tab on the top left, type the name of the effect, for example, multiband compressor, and drag it to your clip. If I record my sound with my Rode NTG3 microphone, I usually use these five effects you see on the screen right now. Find these effects in the Effects tab, drag them on your clip, and choose the recording option after accessing editing mode in the effects control panel. Pay attention to the order, it's also pretty important. Just stop the video, take a screenshot, and try to use these effects to your clip. Important thing is that for every other environment and microphone, for example this popular Rode Video Micro, it may work a little bit differently. For cheaper microphones that are not picking up a lot of low frequencies, you may just stick to the only this one effect, which is a multi-band compressor with the option Broadcast. This will make your voice sound brighter and louder without additional manipulations. This effect I almost always apply, regardless of the microphone I use. If your environment is not so quiet and after applying multiband compressor broadcast effect you hear a lot of noise, you may also use denoise or de-reverb effects. They work pretty similar from what I'm able to hear, but of course you may interchange them and listen if using one or another makes any difference for you. For both of them, I suggest to not go over 20% as your sound will start distorting pretty heavily. This is a test 1, 2, 3, this is a test 1, 2, 3, this is a test 1, 2, 3, this is a test 1, 2, 3. This is a test 1, 2, 3, this is a test 1, 2, 3, this is a test 1, 2, 3, this is a test 1, 2, 3. The flow I presented right now works great if you have just a few clips because this method is quite time consuming, but what if you have a lot of clips in your timeline? Well, there is a much faster way, which I will mention in tip number 5. But now, let's move to tip number 4. To make your voice sound better in your videos, make the sound levels even. Nobody wants to get a heart attack from an unexpected sound out of nowhere. Nobody wants to constantly change the volume of the video while watching it. And of course, there is a simple way to keep your volume constant without changing it in each and single clip on your timeline by dragging the levels up and down or changing the values in the effects controls. There is an amazing and fast way to do that. I first saw that on a David Linger's channel, and to be honest, now I use it in every single video of mine. The effect is called Dynamics. Basically what it does, it's limiting your peaking audio and boosting the silent pieces, so they all stay on more or less the same level. What you need to do is to just find this effect in the Effects tab, drag it onto your clip, and then access the Effects Controls tab. From there, click on Edit, and here begins the most interesting stuff. First of all, we need to check what is the lowest level of our clip. We need to know the value to later input it into our effect. To find it out, have a look at the graph on your soundtrack. Find the place where you speak the most quietly and press play. On the right side of the Premiere workspace, you will see the jumping levels. So in my case, from what I can see, the lowest level while I was talking was minus 20 decibels. Let's input this number into our threshold field under the compressor tab. Let's check it as active, by the way. Next field we need to adjust is makeup. The formula of this value is very simple. You need to add to your threshold the amount around 5 or 7 decibels and input it to the makeup as a positive number, getting rid of minus. So in our case it is 15 decibels. Last tab that we need to activate is a limiter, which is preset to minus 1 decibel, which is totally fine. I just need to activate it by checking this tab. Now, when we listen to the sound before and after applying the effect, you will 100% hear the difference, as now our sound has the level even across the entire track. Most probably the reason is that your editing monitor is not properly calibrated, and in today's video I'm gonna tell you how to do this without any expensive tools. Pretty fast, and the most important, it really works. Fifth tip that I wanted to share with you today is more related to the sound organization and the last finishing touches that will transform your work into a pure pleasure, and the sound itself will be just let's just simplify and call it ergonomics and polishing. In previous tips, I showed how you can apply particular sound effects to the particular sound clips, and this is totally fine if you choose such an approach, but what if you have a lot of audio clips and you don't want to waste time by copying and pasting every effect to each of them? Well, here's where Audio Track Mixer comes to help us. From the main menu, choose Window, Audio Track Mixer, and right away you'll see plenty of different switches which look scary, but don't be afraid, they are really simple and will help us to simplify our sound editing flow. Basically, what a single column in this mixer does, it affects not every audio clip separately, but the entire audio track. And the number of items in the mixer is exactly the same as the number of audio tracks we have on our timeline, including the master track, where all the soundtracks from our project are mixing all together. You might even change their names to know exactly what you are working with right now. And all these soundtrack mixes finally will meet at a master track. So let me show you what I normally do with all these toggles to give you the idea how to easily nail crispy audio end to end with a very simple example. First of all, let's assume we haven't applied any effects to any of our sound clips, as we want to do that for the entire soundtrack. We have several audio clips, all of them are located on the first track, so obviously they are in the first column of our mixer. If you have doubts, just press play and you'll see which column is blinking. So first thing that I'll do, I will expand this effects panel by clicking this small arrow over here. And I will start adding our effects for the voice that I've mentioned in the tip number 3. That's it! Now every single sound clip on our track number 1 is affected by these effects. But what if I want to add more than 5 effects to my track number 1? Well, unfortunately, Premiere Pro for some reason has the limit of 5 effects from the mixer level. But of course, there is a very nice workaround for that. To add the sixths or more effects, you need to go to your timeline, put your cursor somewhere in the area of your tracks, and right-click. Here you'll see a bunch of options, but we are interested in the one called Add Audio Submix Track. After clicking it, you will notice one more column has appeared in our mixer, and as a reflection of it, additional informative track on our track list. This additional submix column in our mixer is not tied to any of our active tracks on the timeline. This is more like an additional level where you may apply additional effects. So in this new submix column, I will add my dynamics effect that I described in tip number 4 to make my voice levels sound equal. As you can see at this point in time, my voice track goes straight to mastering track. The same happens to my submix track. But I want this dynamics effect being applied to my voice track to have an entire number of effects, 6. To do that, from this small tab, I will just simply choose my submix track, and now the flow looks this way. My voice track, after going through the submix, is getting to mastering. Amazing! And the last thing I always do in my mastering column is limiting the sound to reduce peaking. As we see, the sound is hitting maximum and may get red, which may hurt our ears. We'll just add one simple effect, which is called mastering. In the editing mode, just put everything to 0%, and in the very last option, output gain, input minus 0.3 decibels. With these settings, you will not be hitting the maximum levels, but at the same time, your audio will sound crispy and loud. Alright guys, this was a pretty long video with a lot of information, but I have a reward for your patience. If you don't want to set up everything on your own, I have great news for you. In the description to this video, you'll find a link to my online store with a free Premiere Pro template that I created with all these presets done together with audio track mixer and some extra stuff. You can modify it as you wish, remove unnecessary sound effects or change there whatever you want to change. Just check it out, it's free, it's ready to use, and hopefully you'll love it. Who doesn't like free stuff? And of course, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments, like this video if it was helpful, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that yet, and, well, see you in the next one. Cheers!